copycat when we see it. Jane then says, but these aren't even my design. They're from Grace. Judge 3 turns to Grace and asks if it's true. And Grace said, yes, but I would never use them for major projects, nor call them my work. I just use sketches of them as inspirations for my own designs. Judge 3 says, well, that was clear from your presentation. The judge turns back to Jane and says, now, Miss Jane, this is a clear case of plagiarism, and I do hope your school is merciful in this matter. After the presentation was over, the chairman screamed at the professor in front of everyone, not realizing he just revealed all the blackmailing and the secret grade deal. Jane tried to call out Grace on how you screwed me over, but it really didn't matter. No one listened to Jane's attempt and slander, and she was kicked out of the school. Chairman pretty much lost all support and had to resign, and was replaced by a far more honorable and competent one. So, what the heck is the purpose of even being in that class, when your dad just blackmails the teacher to give you good grades anyway? What's that really gonna achieve in the future? She's just gonna graduate from that school not knowing how to design anything. And that, my friends, wraps up another episode of our / Pro Revenge. Guys, if you missed the last episode, OP's scumbag aunt neglects her dying mother, and basically drains her life savings, and OP comes to save the day. Check it out if you missed it, and I'll see you guys in the next one. I love you.
Hey there, Mr. Reddit here. Welcome back to another episode of r/ Entitled Parent Stories. Our first story we'll be reading today. Karen mother-in-law demands a key to my house. After that, I recruited an unwitting army to annoy a jerk. And after that, Karen tries to get my pet duck put down. Now for every thumbs up this video gets, one Karen does not get a key to the house. I'll break a window if I have to. So please smash that like button. And if you're new, subscribe and turn on notifications for new stories from Reddit every single day. Karen mother-in-law demands a key to my house. My wife and I recently moved into a new house because my wife wanted to get closer to her parents. I agreed as long as we had an understanding that this didn't mean they would just be stopping over unannounced and that we still had to maintain boundaries with them. We found a house about 30 minutes from where my in-laws lived, and I figured that would give us enough of a buffer so that they would have to let us know whenever they wanted to stop by. My wife completely agreed to this before we moved. A couple of weeks after we moved in, my wife texted me while I was at work to tell me that her mom wanted to drop off some items for our kids at the house. I told her I was unable to leave work to let her in, but reminded her that we had hidden a spare key in case of emergencies and that we should tell her mom where it is. Mother-in-law found the key and got in, but I was already kind of frustrated that mother-in-law wasn't respecting our boundaries, but I figured I could always hide the key in a different spot later so that mother-in-law wouldn't keep using it. So that's what I did. I hid the key in a different location and showed my wife where it was in case she ever needed it. Not even 2 weeks later, my mother-in-law texted me while I was at work, saying that she was at our house again and couldn't find the spare key. I told her that I had moved it and that she would have to wait until either my wife or I come home for us to let her in. She kept texting me and trying to call me, but I didn't answer her calls and texted her that I was at work and was unable to help her. When I got home that night, my wife was upset with me that I wouldn't tell mother-in-law where the spare key was and tried to convince me that we should just give them a key so that it wouldn't be a hassle. I told her I didn't want them to have a key because mother-in-law has already proven she doesn't respect our boundaries. I also reminded my wife that she had agreed to all of this when we moved and that I was getting frustrated that both her and mother-in-law seemed to be disregarding my feelings on this so quickly after we moved in. I told her that the spare key was for emergencies, not for mother-in-law to use whenever she decided she wants to come to our house. My wife got kind of huffy and said that I was purposely trying to push her family away. I told her that I was trying to maintain boundaries that we had both agreed on. She had started making passive-aggressive comments to me about asking my permission to have her parents over. I told her this was exactly the kind of situation I was worried about before we moved, and her behavior is starting to make me regret agreeing to it. I told her that I agreed to move closer for her, and all I ask is that she respect some very simple boundaries, but she's acting like a child about it. Both her and mother-in-law now think I'm being a jerk, but I think they are steamrolling boundaries and hoping that I will cave. Well, who do you agree with? OP or his wife? Please let us know. If I still had a mother, she'd be over here all the time. Thank God you don't, Karen. Thank God you don't. I recruited an unwitting army to annoy a jerk. Back in the early 90s, my friend